So if I was buying a 240mm all-in-one liquid cooler today, these are the two options that I'd personally be looking at. The Kraken X52 from NZXT and the new H100i Platinum or Pro from Corsair. The choice isn't simple though, as they're both great coolers and both have a list of pros and cons that we'll be taking a look at today, as well as thermal and noise tests. So Corsair have been bringing us 240mm all-in-one liquid coolers for a very long time, and there's been very many iterations, but after so many years, there's only so much you can improve on. For example, the H100i Platinum is literally just the H100i Pro, but now with RGB fans. That's okay though, because the H100i Pro was already a great cooler. The first to use the Asetek Generation 6 pump that can spin over 4000 RPM and a fairly tasteful design for the block cover. It's important to note that a lot of what I'm saying about the H100i Platinum also pertains to the H100i Pro, seeing as there's a lot more important details to cover here than just the additional RGB fans that we've got, which really is the only difference between the two as far as I've been told. Now, the Kraken X52 and the new H100i both share features that I really appreciate in a closed loop cooler. One of the most important traits being rotatable inlet and outlet ports on the block. This way you can easily fit these 240mm AIOs in small form factor builds like the NK71 and Ryzen Tech Ophion Evo without having to worry about the rigidity and angle of the tubing entering the block. For example, both EVGA's CLC240 and Fractal Design's S24 have tubing that enters the block in a very rigid and unforgiving manner. Not only does this not make them suitable for small form factor builds, but even in a mid-tower case, that flexibility is definitely appreciated. Spec-wise, the Corsair H100i Platinum is using the new Gen 6 Asetek pump, whereas the Kraken X52, a cooler that has been out for about 2 years now, still uses the widely popular Gen 5 pump that tops out at 2400 RPM. Cable management for the new H100i is slightly better than the Kraken X52 in my opinion, as here it's a lot cleaner with less cabling overall. I also do really like the low profile block look of the H100i Platinum and Pro. However, whether you prefer this over the very popular Infinity Mirror block on the Kraken is going to be completely up to you. The main difference, of course, between the two coolers are the fans. We've got static pressure AirP 120mm fans on the Kraken X52, which can spin up to 2200 RPM and actually perform surprisingly well. And the H100i Platinum features the maglev RGB fans that can spin up to 2400 RPM. RGB on the H100i is pretty good overall. Tons of lighting options, which we're not going to go through all of them. It's controlled by their IQ software, which I've actually had some great experience with personally. And both the fans and the block are fully customizable, with the block having two separate lighting zones. NZXT's cam software is good too, but has its moments here and there. On the Kraken X52 and the entire Kraken series for that matter, they do not have RGB fans. So if that's something that you're after, that's going to be an additional cost, definitely worth considering. Okay, now onto the good stuff, and let's finally talk about CPU thermals. So here, since the pump cable on the H100i Platinum is a 3-pin cable and I actually couldn't control it in the BIOS on this B350 motherboard, Hardware Info 64 reported that it was spinning at 4300 RPM the entire time, and honestly, I could barely hear it inside the Fractal Design Meshify C. So a big plus there, but otherwise, thermals for the H100i seem to be a little bit warmer than both the Kraken X52 and Deepcool Castle 240 RGB. Not sure why this is, to be honest, since we do have that faster new generation pump. I did expect thermals to be about a degree or two better. The only other variable left to point the finger to is of course those maglev fans, and so after I tested those, I swapped them out to the Noctua NFA 12x25s, and we do see a pretty significant drop, 4 degrees cooler now at 2000 RPM and about 1 degree cooler at 1500 RPM. Out of the box though, the X52 Kraken is the superior cooler thermally, but is also louder both at 1500 RPM and 2000 RPM than the H100i Platinum. When both coolers were at 1500 RPM, the H100i was 1.7 dBA quieter than the X52, and the Deepcool Castle was even quieter than that at 43.1 dBA. Still though, if you were considering upgrading your radiator fans, the Noctua NFA 12x25 proves itself as a much superior radiator fan than both the Corsair maglev fans and the NZXT AirP 120s, where it operates at just 38.2 dBA at 1500 RPM in our test conditions. So the faster Gen 6 pump doesn't seem to make a whole difference here, seeing as that is the main variable between the X52 and H100i Platinum, aside from the different fans. And actually, taking a look at thermals again, I did in fact test both AIOs with the same fans, and the X52 somehow came out about half a degree cooler. Considering that most of you will likely be running these coolers at around 1500 RPM when at full load, you're going to see about a 4 to 5 degree difference in favor of the Kraken X52, and testing showed that this was primarily due to the maglev fans, which don't seem to be optimized for radiator performance. And pricing has not been confirmed yet for the H100i Platinum on my end, but be sure to check those links down below, and there you'll find the current pricing on pretty much everything that we've taken a look at today. All in all, the H100i Platinum is nothing revolutionary over the H100i Pro, basically just RGB fans, but I really would have liked to see an optimized fan design for the Platinum series instead of RGB. I guess for those who want optimized thermal and acoustic performance, there's always the Noctua NFA12x25, which remains a worthy upgrade. Both AIOs will perform pretty much identically with the same pair of fans, so at the end of the day, I recommend choosing the cooler that you think looks the best or is the most affordable if you do plan on upgrading those fans. So guys, let me know your thoughts down below on the H100i Platinum. It's not a very exciting cooler in my opinion, because the H100i Pro already exists where we got the main upgrades, which was that Gen 6 pump. I'd actually really like to see how the Kraken X52 goes with that new Generation 6 Acetec pump. So NZXT, if you are watching this, I'd love to see an X52 V2 sometime in the near future so we can test those pump speeds out there. As always guys, a huge thanks for watching. Subscribe down below if you haven't already, and I will see you all in the next one.